doing my first video. Getting back in the gym, and I'm just doing about 2 packs of cigarettes a day for, I don't know, 3 years. Just before, tomorrow will be a month, no cigarettes. Just dip, and I'm going to start doing some reviews. First off, I think I want to use that, boys. We'll get one. Mudjugs.com, Darcy and Jeff make an awesome product. Tip it upside down right here. Half full of dip. Nothing. Nothing coming out. Alright. Let's see what we got today. Alright. Got 2 dips here that I like a lot. The first one I've been stuck on so far is the Coke Southern Blend. Found this, I started with the pouches and three skull flavors and all that crap, and then worked my way up a little bit of this stuff. I've been doing this, I just bought a log of this, haven't opened it yet, so I feel like this can uncrack. Ready to go, I'll crack that on cam. And then take this guy up today, first pinch, fell in love. Only problem is getting gator lip like a motherfucker. And one pinch, I'll be good for the day, and the rest I'll have to do the Southern Blend or something else. But right now, I prefer this one over this one, as far as taste goes. But I can dip this all day and have no problems. But as soon as I get to do one pinch of this, I got gator lip like a motherfucker. Another thing I bought today, I bought the Grizzly Long Cut 1900. I took one pinch, I hated it. I don't know if it's just now because I'm getting into dip again, but right now I guess this is not for me. But I might give it a try in a month or two to see how it goes. And then my dumbass decided, I saw somebody dipping Red Seal, and my dumbass bought the fine cut by mistake. I went to take a pinch of this, I got like 3 pieces of it. I might give that to somebody I know or give it another shot, but right now these guys are off cam, not even gonna touch them. Alright, I guess I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna start with the Coke Straight, and I haven't got the pack my lip down right yet, so I'm gonna do that off cam so you guys don't see me pull my lip out. There we go. Yeah. Big ol' hammer. Anything I like about the straight? You hit with the flavor right away, but the thing is it goes away just as quick as it shows up. It is a great dip, but for me the flavor goes away like less than 15 minutes, and I mean, if I could get it to last longer, it'd be my new favorite, and I think it's a good one. Looking at all of Darcy's videos, Mudjug one on here, and he's got some really good videos, really good informational videos about dipping, about mud jugs. Don't have a mud jug, he's got a video called Why a Mud Jug. Might want to go check that out if you're interested and on the fence about it, because that's what did it for me. I've seen people with him before. I saw the Dodger Boys video. I saw stuff on Tumblr. Seen all kinds of stuff about him, and I was spitting Gatorade bottles for the last month. I just got this less than a week ago, I think. Maybe just about a week. But it's amazing. Like, I keep it in my truck, I put it in the cup holder, it sits there. One thing I might do to it is on the bottom here, put a rubber sticky pad or something so I can put it on the center console of my truck. So I don't have to keep it so far away from me. Actually, got that log of the Southern Blend. I'm taking that and probably going to get another can of the Coke Straight. This weekend I live in Miami, I'm going up to West Palm. Luke Bryan, Jason Aldean concert, if you guys are in the country. That should be an awesome concert, bring my handlers back, I'm going to be set. So far, Coke Straight's doing good, I like it. I can't really describe the flavor. It's got like a kind of a mint. It really reminds me of something, and I can't figure out what it is. It's not anything dip related. It's something like that that dip should not taste like, but it does and it works. I can't describe it. But I remember when I wasn't dipping, I'd see this on the shelves, and I thought it was interesting as hell. So I decided I was going to go see if I could, or I bought one just to try it, and I let it sit in the truck too long. I cracked it as soon as I got it, didn't take a pinch. It sat in the truck for about 2 weeks. I opened it up, and that was the driest dip I've ever seen, and I could not pinch it. It was like powder. So first thing I did after I got, because I started with Grizzly pouches, the wintergreen. Absolutely hated them. They taste like when dip goes bad. I don't know if they don't taste right. I found the Skull Extra pouches in the mint blend. I really liked those, and then one day I went to buy them, and the lady at the gas station accidentally gave me the long cut, and I went with it, and I haven't gone back to pouches. I mean, I've had one or two when I've been out and my buddies have some, but I'll be interested in the Skull Ready Cut if it ever makes it down here to Florida, but until then, it's going to be Copenhagen kind of guy. I mean, I want to try this. I want to try the extra long cut natural and see how that does. I kind of want to try the Coke whiskey blend if I can get a hold of that. I've seen it. I saw one can at my local Walmart, and then I saw some online, but I was looking into the stuff online and all the people talking about it, you get hit crazy, crazy customs duty fees. I saw one, of course this guy was from Canada, but he ordered like $40 worth of dip, which on the website I was on was nothing. You could get, I saw 10 can boxes of Copenhagen Straight for like $12. I paid $18 for a 5-can log of this at Walmart. Probably the best price I can get down here at gas stations. This guy right here is going for about $4 or $5 a pop. Something like this. You're talking $6. Skull, $6 or $7. For me to go and get this at Walmart for $18 for 5 of them, that's insane. That's what, a little over $3 a can, maybe $3.50, $3.75. But yeah, I feel bad for those guys in Canada. He ordered $50 on the website. They hit you with taxes on the website. So, and then like a $20 shipping fee to the U.S. because I was trying to do it. And I was trying to order $20 worth of dip, a can of a tub of Stoker's, and I think just a five can log of this. I'm not sure it was 5 or 10, but they're about the same. And my cart total with the tax and the shipping and all that kind of stuff came out to like $50. $50 for $20 worth of dick. That doesn't make sense to me. But this guy, he ordered it, he pays for everything, he pays his $50. Or he pays for the $50 worth of dip, it came out to like $100. And he gets his package in the mail and they're asking for another, the customs is asking for $240 on top of what he already paid. And he said, screw it, sent it back, he couldn't get his money back from the website. So I'm just gonna wait around, see what they have around here. I've already found two that I like. Stick with them until something else comes down here. But I mean, these labels, the warning labels, the this product will kill you labels, piss me the fuck off. It's like you go buy a pack of cigarettes. I wish I still had one I could show you. It's one label on the side of the box. One label. This one, I got it there, so like a third of the face of the can is a fucking warning. And then pack the can all the way around. This product will kill you. Like, that's not what I want to see when I'm dipping this, because it's all lies. You do your research, the chances of you getting mouth cancer, face cancer, whatever, is slim to none with this. If you get it, you're gonna get it anyway. And the worst thing that could happen is you have your teeth fall out. That's if you don't take care of your teeth. If you take care of your teeth and you switch from top to bottom, or take a break for a couple of days, let your gums rest, and weigh off the wintergreen and the grizzly, you'll be fine. I'm brushing my teeth like 4 or 5 times a day. Just to be on the safe side. It's not even necessary to do that much. But I'm not going to risk it. But oh no, this is a hell of a lot better for me than the damn cigarettes were. Especially, and as far as money goes, even if I'm paying, because I don't really dip all that much right now. You know, I just started back up. I'm doing about a can every 2 or 3 days. Maybe if I'm out somewhere, I'll do a little bit more. Maybe a can will last me a day and a half, whatever. But I got this for 3-something. Pack of cigarettes, I go through 2 a day. That's $14, depending on where I get it. Somewhere between 12 and 14. Maybe 10 if I'm lucky and I can find a deal in Hialeah where they're not charging cash. So, I was spending close to $100 a week. Most of my paycheck was cigarettes. And with this, I don't have that problem. Saving money, saving my lungs, and you can't beat that. Still ain't good for you, but the lesser of two evils, I'll deal with that. I mean, I'll pick my poison, but the other thing is, down here in Miami, it's the summertime. I mean, we have 2 seasons. We have a few days where it's cold in the winter, and all year long, it's summer. And when it's summer, it rains. It rains every day, pretty much, about somewhere between noon and 4. And when I say rain, it rains. And I drive 16 miles each way to work at about 4 o'clock. So I do that 4 to 6 days a week, depending on what my schedule is. I can't tell you the number of times I've had to throw a cigarette or that I just lit out the window because it started pouring. And I was not going to get soaked over a cigarette. With dip, I don't have to worry about that. I got my mud jug, I spit in it, I set it down, I have my windows up, I have my AC crank, I'm happy. I don't have to worry about my car smelling like shit. I don't smell like shit when I walk in somewhere. Like, with dip, you pack a lip, you're going, spitting, you get somewhere where it's not really socially acceptable, if you want to call it that, all you got to do is go in, or before you go in, drop your lip, rinse your mouth out a little bit, you're good to go. Nobody's going to know you were dipping. And it's a whole lot more discreet if, like me, my mom, I'm 21 years old, but my mom, she found out I was smoking cigarettes. He blasted me. I didn't hear the end of it for like 3 months, every day. Why the hell are you smoking? Why are you smoking? You shouldn't be smoking. This, I mean, she hasn't found it yet, but she told me straight up she'd rather see me doing this than smoking. Especially, like, not leaving bottles of dip spit or cups of dip spit all over the house, like, waiting to get knocked over. I got this. I clean this out every day when I get home from work. I clean it out with clean the funnel out with a sponge, hot water, and a little bit of soap in the actual jug. I drop a little bit of Listerine in there, swish it around, and it's good to go. Never smells. Even when I leave it in my truck, I have a little bottle of Listerine in the truck. I'll drop a little bit in there if I'm leaving it during the day. I don't have any smell. Like with the Gatorade bottles, I was just spitting those, like that's all I spit in. First off, you go out somewhere, it looks nasty. I mean, this is coming from a dipper. So, you can't just leave you can't walk around at a party of a bunch of people that don't dip with a bottle like that. People get disgusted. I used to. But, thing is, Gatorade bottles, you spit in one of those all day, you cap it, you leave it in the truck, you open it up and it's got that smell. I always thought it smelled like rotten cabbage. And that stuff is just nasty. Like, I've had times where, and it wasn't even hot out that day, or that hot. I mean, it was like maybe 80 instead of 95. And I left it in my truck overnight. I come out about 10 o'clock in the morning. I work at night, so I'm coming out, getting the bottle so I can have a dip in the morning, get everything going. And I'd sit in the truck, open that bottle up, and instantly the truck would have that smell. And I could not do that anymore. I bought the Navy digital camo, and came with the free black. I ended up liking the black a little bit more. I gave the Navy camo to a buddy of mine. I'm trying to get as many of my friends that dip to get these, because this beats the hell out of the bottle. And this does not, like, I saw a bunch of videos today of people trying to make them out of Powerade bottles, water bottles. Nothing beats the real thing, guys. I've tried all that. It doesn't work. All it takes is one good knock to knock that over, knock the top out of it, and you're done. And you got dip shit all over your truck, your pants, wherever the hell you are, and that's no fun. And the other thing is, you can't mistake this for a drink. And even if you do, if you're drunk, whatever, you go try to take a sip from this, you're not going to get very far. Because there ain't nothing coming up out of there. Only thing I still have to worry about that I still get confused with is I'll be drinking a beer at a party or something, not thinking that I drop my spit in my beer. Usually it happens when I just open it, so it's just a waste of beer, but I'll get used to it over time. Well, I think that's enough for my first video. I just hit the 20-minute mark, so let you guys go. I might do another one in a couple days when I get something new. I'm going to be going out of town on Saturday, so this is Thursday. I don't know what I'll get to, but maybe when I come back, I'll have some new stuff I can try out. But thanks, guys. Subs. Check out Mudjug 1, Darky and Jeff. Check out Outlaw Dipper. Chris Dips 1. Copen and Grizzly. I think that's what his name is. He's got some good stuff. A bunch of guys out there that are doing some good stuff. Check them out. Check out Redneck Nation. They've got some awesome stuff. We can't wait till I get paid again, so I can go crazy and get some stuff from them. All right, guys, this is Southern Dipper 1. Checking out. Catch you guys next time.